Hi, Chris Chinnock here. Display Week 2024. I'm in the Tianma booth. We're going to take a look at their smart cockpit showings. So let's take a look. First of all, they've got a number of displays here. Let's start in the back cockpit here, the back of the. So this may be a little bit hard to see, but this is a rear seat entertainment display. And if you look closely, there's actually a little display kind of embedded up high. And then there's some kind of either a half mirror with some magnification. It just basically projects this flat plane further out. It looks like maybe 2 or 3 feet in front of me instead of instead of being 2 feet in front of me where this headrest is, it feels like it's more like 4 or 5 feet away. So that's a nice feature to have in the back of the in the back seat of the car. Very simple to implement. If we move into the cockpit, these are all of the displays that they're going to be. We're going to take a look at here, and I'll put these specs up. I'll hold these specs up a little bit later in the video. I just want to show you some displays as we go through them. So here is the this is the transparent 8-inch octagon micro LED display. As you can see, it's transparent. The idea here is this is going to replace the side mirror on the car. Now we questioned why it needs to be transparent. Well, it's really a kind of the reason is the artifact. It's an artifact of this demo. In reality, this would sit between the A pillar on the side of the car and above the dashboard, so you would be able to see out onto the road, but then still have this this side view mirror application. The resolution looks fine. The luminance looks a little low to me. This is supposed to be 1500 nits, but again, maybe a little bit low in my opinion. These, I believe all the micro LEDs are on LTPS backplanes, so it's active matrix. 55% transparency is what I believe is this one. Over here in their cockpit, they have several displays. These two right here are OLED displays. That's feature Corning's Living Hinge Glass. It's a special thin glass that obviously is meant to move, but there's mechanical structure behind this thing that allows it to actually fold into the cockpit. So if I press the button here for the demo, you can see this thing starts to roll back into the cockpit. So the idea is you can have this kind of nice rounded cockpit if you want, just for ambiance purposes, and if you want to bring it back up and when you're driving, this can come up to a straight position, maybe a little bit more forward, depending on where you are. Over here is what they call a stretchable display, or I'm sorry, a slidable display. It's 13 inch, and it's supposed to just slide right into the dashboard. Now it's not working. I guess it apparently broke a little bit, but that's the idea. And again, it's kind of a these are all really concepts to show to the Tier 1 and the automakers to see what they might like to integrate. Down below here is another micro LED display. This is a 9.38-inch one, a little bit lower luminance, 800 nits, again, active matrix on LTPS, but this is a 70% transparency. So you might be able to see whatever you've got kind of down below here. Yeah, as you can see, you can see my hand through this thing a little bit. Those are the main displays that are part of their cockpit displays solution. So, Chris Chinnock for Insight Media.